Hi guys, this is Oliver, and today we're going to review Once Upon a Snowman, a Frozen short film released 3 weeks ago in 2020. This is yet another Frozen adventure featuring Olaf. After last year seeing Frozen 2 with my cousins Ari and Sienna, I thought that Frozen 2 was pretty good, I think. I didn't hate it like a lot of people did, and I thought that fans of Frozen thought that Olaf was pretty funny in that film. Then we got not a lot of people asked what happened with Olaf in the middle of the original Frozen film, but we got a short film about it, and I was pretty excited for it because I'm a real big fan of Olaf in the Frozen franchise. I thought it was pretty funny. He's one of the highlights of the first of the Frozen 1 and Frozen 2. So yeah, now I'm going to review the short film, and right off the bat, there's not really that much to say about the short film. You know, it's only 5 minutes long. It's way too short. So I'm going to start with the negative for you guys, but I can try. I'll do my best here to keep you guys occupied. Let's do this. So now, starting with this negatives here, one big thing I did not really like about the short film, just like I said, was that it's way too short. It was only like 5 minutes long, basically. I mean, it is actually 12 minutes long, but it's only 12 minutes long if you count the end credits. And the end credit was really long on many of the Disney Plus short films, because of the detached version and everything. That I'm pretty tired about. And also, there's not really that much that happens here. If you haven't seen this short film, and if you have missed this one, it's not really nothing special, you know. If you're a big fan of Frozen, then I think you should go and check it out, but it's not really nothing special. You will just get to see Olaf getting chased by some wolves again, you know. And although as much as I really liked that whole entire sequence in this short film, we got to see Olaf getting chased by some wolves in Olaf's Frozen adventure. There were a lot of similarities to Olaf's Frozen adventure and this movie and this short film, but there are still a couple of things I really like here, to be honest. I think that as much as I really like the animation, I thought that the animation was not really something new, really. I mean, they tried a lot of new things for the animation of Frozen 2, but here it feels like they used the same animation as they did in the first film, but with some upgraded qualities, you know. It feels like, you know, that opening scene with Let It Go, where you get to see Elsa again. It felt like that scene was like the exact same shot as the original Frozen film. It's like the same, basically, but with different angles and everything. But I still really like the short film, to be honest. It's really cute, I think. It's fun seeing Olaf again. I think that it was pretty funny, but I still think that one big complaint I had with the jokes here was that the jokes were pretty much exactly the same from the ones in Frozen 2 and in Frozen 1. He did pretty like the same jokes, you know, but there are still a couple of good laughs here. It's pretty funny, I think, especially when he said that he was walking on snow and he's made of snow. That was pretty funny, I think. And also really like the music here, to be honest. I think that the music was pretty beautiful. I think that in general, Once Upon a Snowman is a pretty enjoyable short film, I think. And also think it's pretty cute, I think. I really like the ending when, you know, Olaf is playing with that wolf, and then that wolf runs away and then he smiles into the camera. That was really, really cute. And the music that was playing during that scene was really beautiful. That was one of my favorite scenes besides the opening scene. Yeah, I really liked Once Upon a Snowman. I thought it was pretty enjoyable, I think. There were a lot of things I liked here, to be honest. So for me, I had a lot of enjoyment out of Once Upon a Snowman, but I still think that it's okay, I think. It's nothing special, you know. If you're, there are a lot of great, really good Easter eggs and movie references to the original Frozen film, which is one big thing I really liked about this episode, short film, to be honest. But other than that, I think you should go and check it out. If you're a big fan of Frozen, then I think you should watch this short film. But if you couldn't care less, then you should not want to watch this one. It's on Disney Plus if you want to watch it, if you want to. But I'm not forcing you to. Anyways, before this video ends, first I want to tell you guys about some movie news and some ride news. We got our first look at the Guardians of the Galaxy roller coaster at Epcot, and it looks awesome. It reminds me a lot of the Wild Mouse coaster, that it's a mini cart ride and it spins around also. I'm really excited to go on that ride. I didn't really remember when it's going to open, but it's at Epcot. Yeah, it looks awesome. And also, the new Star Wars Holiday Special Lego movie has dropped on Disney Plus, and I haven't seen it yet, but yeah, let me know what you think about it in the comments below, and I might do a movie review of that on my Oliver Ekman 2020 Christmas special. I don't know. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you guys next time. Oh, it's so cold. It's frozen. It's so cold. I live!